In the year 2049, the Earth's surface has become much hotter and radioactive due to a cascading climate crisis. Permafrost thaws, trapped methane gases escape, polar ice caps melt completely, and the sea levels rise, flooding mostly all coastline cities and low-lying areas. A lot of the surviving cities burn from out-of-control grassland and forest fires. This has forced humanity to go either underground, in space, or escape underwater. We chose going underwater because as the ice caps melted, the shorelines flooded. A perfect habitable zone was created. In the wreckage of the coastal cities, we were able to salvage, reuse, and repurpose many valuable building materials. In the climate chaos pre-2049, one team has managed not only to survive, but thrive. This team is known as the FRL 612 community. Using our amazing collaboration skills, we have managed to make this all possible. Here in the sea, we have created a space to live, work, worship, and play as a community should, with all of the important elements a sustainable community should have. Our main entrance is here at the dock. We have two elevators, one going up to the surface and the other going down into our community. This dome has a map and an exceptional view. From here, you can see many of our common public domes, research centers, floating gardens, library commons, living quarters, recreational sports center, and a mass transit hub. All domes are constructed from extremely strong nano glass that can withstand thousands of atmospheres of pressure per square centimeter. We have rules and laws in place like every organized community should have. Mostly, we operate on the honor system and trust. No trespassing is allowed in private domes, and breaking property not owned by you is also illegal. A few exits are provided in case of emergencies, catastrophic system failures, or natural disaster. All doors are automatic. They shut and latch, watertight, immediately after you walk through. This helps prevent a cascade of flooding throughout our community if there is a crack in one of our domes or corridors. The water will not pass through these doors once they are sealed. This is the Church of Bongo Cat, where non-denominational community worship is allowed and encouraged. The trident of Lord Neptune, God of the Sea, looks over us all. The main entrance stairs and tree dome. Once you come down these stairs, you enter domed space. The main area connects to most other domes and corridors. We have a nice big tree providing some fresh air and natural oxygen. It is a secondary source of our oxygen. Our primary source uses a generator that extracts the oxygen directly from the seawater and also cools our domes with a built-in air conditioner, which creates a very comfortable and climate-controlled environment. For electricity, our facility uses primarily geothermal energy, which is unlike other domes and submarines which rely on nuclear reactors. This dome relies more on its citizens and is more cost-efficient and safer thanks to our geothermal reactor instead of nuclear power. The entire community's heating requirements come from underwater geothermal caves. We are using geothermal energy for our most powerful equipment, technology, and research. The liquid magma, which is contained in a heat-proof containment cell, heats the water and uses steam to spin a turbine, which generates electricity. Since we are underwater, using magma to heat the water is more easily collected than burning fossil fuels. This will not create air pollution to ruin our world again, and it is also fairly easy to utilize because of the many sea caves and deep ocean trenches. We are researching the use of tidal energy for electricity, agriculture, and climate controls. We have a giant cold storage space to keep materials, as well as food and seeds, protected in case our community decides to expand as our population grows, or we are trapped under the ocean for prolonged periods of time. As we approach our science and agriculture research domes, we have access to all of humanity's priceless information and scientific papers. The entire contents of the internet have been downloaded, and all scientific research has been backed up for safekeeping, so that we can learn and teach others to respect and protect nature. We all can help in many ways. Together, We can learn from our past to create a better future world. Chloe's Dome. Private domes and living quarters with beds, bathrooms, and other amenities are spread throughout for individuals who work and live in our community. Our citizens' living quarters are close to where they work, which cuts down on the daily commute and is more energy efficient. This is Emma's Underwater Research Lab, where we study ecology, marine science, and biochemistry. We have several living quarters and domes surrounding this research facility. Just past this area is a corridor which leads to our lab above water. Connected to this lab is our floating garden, which provides all our fruits, vegetables, and herbs. We moved it there to the surface so the plants could have access to sunlight for photosynthesis. We grow lots of different foods, including fruits and vegetables. We made our floating agricultural island by collecting the many trillions of plastic bottles that are floating around in the open ocean in enormous garbage patches. If you put plastic bottles into biodegradable mesh bags and then plant mangrove seeds in a little bit of soil, the root structures will hold all the bags together. The bags will float, and you can put wood pallets on top of them to support even more weight. These mesh bags and mangrove tree roots spread out underwater, which provide a habitat for baby and juvenile fish species that live just underneath our floating garden. While the mangrove tree's roots hold the island together, the trees themselves also provide us with an effective windbreak from strong offshore breezes that might damage our crops. Using plastic bottles and naturally strong and resilient trees like mangroves is cost-effective, as well as super helpful to the environment. Just under the water, near the floating garden and agricultural research area, we have a protected pollinator dome with many butterflies, bees, and hives. It also doubles as a public nature dome with benches, so like a park, people can just stay and read or enjoy a calming natural environment or stop and smell the roses and other flowers. The bee species we are most interested in are the ones that have become at risk on the surface and are on the cusp of becoming extinct in their natural terrestrial habitats. Mark's Underwater Athletics and Recreational Center. We have a giant arena for soccer matches and other recreational athletics. It is a great way to get together as a community, stay fit, and just have some fun. Communal gatherings and recreation are both very important things to do, as they improve social skills and give you something to talk about with your friends and family. To get between our major dome clusters, we have a mass transit network of minecarts. In reality, they are meant to be high-speed magnetic levitation pods that travel through a tube which is vacuum-sealed. This mass transit network allows us to travel vast distances and access more amenities, resources, and natural wonders in our ever-growing and expanding aquatic community. It is a public transit, free for everyone, and we even have a scenic transit route for our enjoyment and for tourism. We have several tourist destinations, such as this mine track around the luxurious kelp forest that goes deep under the bottom and into the sea trench cave. We can also access extremely rare raw minerals from the deep ocean floor, which has an abundance of valuable rare earth minerals, such as silver, gold, copper, magnesium, cobalt, and zinc, that we can use to create our own electronics or trade and sell with the surface dwellers. From our conference center and food court, we can monitor the undersea life or just observe our surroundings and daydream. There are large conference tables and many places to sit, talk, socialize, and eat and drink. We also have our primary desalination plant here, which is where our community gets all of its fresh water. It is pumped through pipes just under the seafloor to all the domes and irrigation systems for the crops. From here, you can also access the underwater abyssal trench, which is another one of our main tourist attractions, as it has many amazing things to see, such as deep sea submersibles and scuba tours that are organized daily. Thank you for listening and watching. We hope you enjoyed our presentation and tour of FRL Class 612's Atlantis II, Future Frontier Community. Feel free to visit anytime.